never camera shy. We're doing the newest challenge. Join the chat room challenge.
Yeah, I'm supposed to stay warm with.
How many blood family members can you connect with challenge?
Dennis is like, I ain't gonna bust it.
Dennis?
I will. Oh, freezing over.
Maybe we can do some like mumble shit. Maybe they'll understand it better.
I hope you're running safe to keep them evil spirits away.
I got some.
There you go.
I'm safe,
busting,
man.
The hex on everybody.
When I bust it, it's gonna be busting the lie.
bust it
every
open.
Conference in the world. Pointing.
Bust it open, baby.
The North Pole.
I'm gonna bust a nigga upside his head if you don't pay me for my weed.
Oh damn. That just happened in New York the other day. I was watching World Star. Two guys were in the street and these dudes were selling weed on their block. And the guy stopped and he said, "Oh man, you gotta let me smack you now." The dude got two smacks on the guys that were selling weed on their block. Hit them pretty good. Smacked them pretty good. For selling weed, bro. But then I seen today there was a guy, they pulled a African-American over in New Jersey, and he had weed on him, and he was all happy and shit because they let him go. He's like, he was just astounded, you know, that they just passed that new law and he didn't have to go to jail for a little bit of weed on him, you know.
Incredible.
Yeah, I mean, they should, you know. Even the cop was like, "We're living in 2021. Weed's definitely not, like, looked at like it used to, you know?"
Well, you gotta look at it like so.
Right. Well, it became, over time, where people started doing more studies on it. And I remember in high school, I did a debate, my first ever debate ever. And I debated somebody on the legalization of marijuana. And this was back in, like, 2004 when marijuana was still considered Class A drug, you know, along with all the other drugs. And I did a stand-up report in school. And after I was done, my teacher was very impressed with me. He pulled me off to the side, brought me up to his desk. And he's like, "Man," he's like, "that report you just did was like a college material." He's like, "That was really good." And like after that, he always like treated me different. He always looked at me different. He always just...
What's wrong with doing with all them drugs?
No, he just liked how I debated the fact that marijuana should have been legal at that time, you know?
Pulled the joint out of his desk drawer or something.
Yeah, he was definitely a hippie. My teacher, he was a hippie. His name was Rush. He was a hippie teacher. But, you know, he was trying to see where we were at with our debates, you know? It was a debate class, and we were debating, and that was the topic that came up. Or he asked what we wanted to do, and I said that's what I chose. And I went and did my studies at home, and I gathered up a report. I didn't think I did as good as I thought, but according to him, he was really impressed and that I came up with all those facts about marijuana, you know, over at that time when it was considered highly dangerous.
They made up a new word in the 1930s, marijuana, to tarnish cannabis and hemp plant.
Yeah, and the hemp was really big thing too, you know.
Marijuana.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Because if you remember, like, I don't know, hemp clothes last a lot longer and they're more durable. That's why, you know, Levi's, I don't remember. But, like, you can still, to this day, like, Wranglers find old jeans and they go for a lot of money still to this day. Like, old pairs of jeans, you know, because they're very durable compared to the new fashion. Because nowadays they want you to rip your shit or they sell you the pants ripped now. And they know nobody's gonna sew anymore. You know, they're just gonna turn around and go buy a new pair. That's why everything just.
They're like, "Oh,
yeah.
All these pants came out ripped at the warehouse."
Yeah.
Like, "Sell
you,
bro." Yeah, that's the new style. Like tight leg. Like, tight leg jeans.
That's the style,
yeah.
Yeah, tight legged jeans.
Wearing ripped clothes is the style.
Dude, I remember we were talking about this the other day. I don't know. I think it was Rex and Max and I, and we were talking about wearing JNCOs and shit. Like, back in grade school, we'd wear JNCO jeans. They were like corduroy jeans. Those big JNCO pants.
We were just watching some really cool Flat Earth videos.
Mm-hmm.
Talking about how it's gonna change the world.
Nice.
I'll be back.
Bro. I mean, it's only a matter of time. The Great Awakening is happening, you know, regardless. There's a lot of information being shed out, and, you know, we know where this is all coming from. We know where the problem exists, and they're saying we're part of that problem when we're actually here opposing it, you know, and pointing it out and telling them, hey, man, we need heaven here. This is hell. You can see it every day if you just sit back
and eyes are on the prize, man.
Look at it at a broader perspective. Because I found out this was hell 3 years ago, man. 3 years ago, I found out this was hell. So it sunk in for me a little bit more, you know. And I mean, you get your confirmations more and more.
Yeah, once you realize that you're in hell, you better start doing something to get out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Making videos pointing to the Holy Grail. Because it's conscious.
Definitely. Definitely, and we gotta remain conscious too of that fact, because, you know, we're getting to the point now where they can't deny us, you know, because there's so many people that are just it's nonstop, you know. There's videos being poured out into the ether. There's blood being poured out into the ether. There's all kinds of equity,
you know.
So much equity is being built up right now. And, you know, that's the key thing. Like, we are building right now. We're building and we're mounting. We're coming together and we're doing it for a common cause of our own survival. It's beautiful, you know. We can actually feel this way and say the things we say and the things we do, you know. It's going to take them a while to catch on, but eventually when enough of us are doing this and showing them this, that we're doing it, nobody's going to knock us off, because there's nobody here to contest us, you know. You know, we're gonna get our tests here along the way. You know, you get one guy here or there that wants to come in and acts like he knows it all, but he can't show you anything, or he can't tell you anything, or he won't come in, or she won't come in and join the chat rooms or even talk to us, you know, when we're here all the time. They see our videos, they're always commenting, always trying to, you know, say something like they have the upper hand or something, and it's just a one-liner no-brainer, you know. Like, come on, man, you got to do better than that. Come talk to us if you think you know what we.
Yeah, we're just in here trying to connect to each other to learn from each other and share knowledge, so we can literally unite peacefully side by side to go to the center of the earth. The Holy Grail Exodus is something that must be accomplished before we die.
Better believe it.
Yeah, you know, I'm just trying to be more and more humble as I go, man. I'm trying to really get a healthy. I want a healthy ego, you know. I'm trying to build a healthy ego, and then that way I can let it go and then go in, you know. Because the egos today are just so brutal, man. It's like, let go of your ego, man. You know, there's just so many people with their egos that are.
You just stand on this roof. Making sure the devil gets his due.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and remain selfless,
Mark,
you know?
Ron.
It's like, open once people drop that ego and then become selfless.
People want to talk smack about blood
like,
over intent.
You can see it, like, as I'm sitting here talking
blood
about
over intent
it.
Is how to take your own soul back.
But, you know, the signs are everywhere, and it's pointing our way out of here, man. And I don't know how anybody could deny that. Like, this was never told to anybody before until now. And then on top of it, it's like they hid this shit in front of us in plain sight. So, you know, you want to sit here and try to call us the fools. Well, we're the ones calling out them that are fooling you. You know, it's like we're the ones calling out the fools. It's like April Fool's.
We're the ones pointing to eternal life.
Like, April Fool's is every day in this place, man. Like, they tell us in plain sight, like, next month it'll be April 1st, April Fool's. Like, they got you. They fooled you on everything. You know, every month, every day on the Gregorian calendar. It's like, where did these fucking holidays even come from? I have no clue, but it's like people are still going to celebrate them, you know? They're still going to ritualistically take a part into these fucking holidays that are just keeping us all enslaved into the bullshit and believing lies, and buying into more lies and then feeding them to your children and then saying, no, no, don't tell them it's not fake. You're going to ruin it for them. It's like, motherfucker, you're ruining everything for us to bring forth heaven on earth because you don't want to get out of your lies and sit here and act like it's normal, you know? It's like everything's the reverse of truth. Play your words in reverse. They're going to tell you, get the fuck out of here. You don't belong here. There's an exit. It's telling you.
Lie to the children about Santa. When you find out that you were lied to, it breaks this trust bond that you have with your parents.
Mm-hmm.
It's
yeah,
very, very mm-hmm. deceptive.
Yeah, it is.
Tooth fairy, the Easter Bunny, Santa Claus, all these lies get so rooted into your reality
all the time
that they just continue to lie. Where do you stop lying?
Yep. And that was a big thing, Michael. I'm sick of being lied to, man. You know, there's got to come a point.
Christ,
it's like, we're innocent people. We had our families taken from us. And, you know, it's like, when do the lies stop? Like, you know, like, where does it end? You know, you can search and search and search, and then you're always going to find the same answer. And it's always the fucking the Zionist Jews and the fucking banksters and all these. I mean, you know, it's just the same people. It always are going to be brought up that are fucking a part of this bullshit. And they're still here. They exist. They're still controlling everything. If not, they're getting stronger with they think, you know, because they're fueling and gassing up just all their products right now, you know, and they could give a fuck less about the American people and the Canadian people because that's what's going on right now. They're fucking literally destroying the working middle class people in the lower, you know, the business owners, the small business owners. That's what they're attacking right now. That's what this all is. It's to get the small business owners to close their shops down and, you know, have to start over.
And this is Saturnale, yeah.
They're getting paid, man. All these companies and shit, like the big-headed companies, the Googles, the fucking, you know, all the bullshit. They're the ones that are getting the paydays right now. They're the ones that are taking cash out and everybody else is fucked because the rich are getting richer right now. And the poor are going to stay poor. And it's like, what equity do you have left? They're taking the money from you. They're switching it to a new currency. People can't even accept this fact. It's like, what are you going to do? What currency do you have? What currency do you have left? When they're draining literally your banks right now as we speak.
Blood currency is really the
they
only
they don't have any other fucking currency. There's no other way. I mean, if anybody could think of any other way, you know, besides saying, oh, it's Zionist Jew doctrine bullshit. That's what they're trying to, you know, say. Blood over intents, a cult, blood cult. I mean, you can name everything under the sun, you know. Satan's got to get forgiveness to get into heaven.
No doubt.
Satan's got to have forgiveness. We all have to have forgiveness to get into heaven. It's not a, I mean, once people adopt this strategy, they're not going to want to fucking do any harm. They're not going to want to kill anybody. They're not going to want to attack anybody for anything. Because what's the point? It's all fake. Get over it. There's no reason to walk down the fucking street and have to hit somebody because they're selling something. Or, I mean, just whatever. You know, just over anything. Anything of materialistic, you know. It could be a dollar, motherfuckers get shot, you know? Like, it doesn't matter. It's like, why cannot people just adapt this concept, man? Let's just get over this shit. You know, they ain't got it. It's just these low vibrational frequencies that they keep everybody in, you know? They can't get out of these low vibrational frequencies. They're just stuck. They're stuck in this low vibration and they won't let go. They won't give themselves a change. They're asking for change and they're begging for change in their lives, but they won't let that ego down just to, you know, see it for what it is, man. You gotta look to your heart, showing you right there on my screen on an island. You know, you gotta, your heart is the most powerful thing, I think, you know, because when you die, or if your brain goes dead, you're still alive. You're still declared alive if your brain's gone, but once your heart goes, you go, you're done, you know? And you must go inside of your heart, go inside.
Say when you get to the center of the flat earth, your compass will spin in circles. At that point, you'll need your internal compass, your heart chakra.
Mm-hmm.
You'll need the favor of your creator. You better be blood thick when you go to the Holy Grail. Otherwise, you'll never find this invisible mountain.
No, because like Mark said, you could walk right into it, you know? That's the only way you'll be able to find it.